Have you ever clapped someone so hard that they accuse you of cheating? Well, this is not a common occurrence for me, as I am very bad at this game when it comes to PvP. But in this episode, I'll show you how, once in a while, I will hit a clip where another streamer will call me out for cheating and I'll be defended by the admins. But anyway, let's get into it. And right before we get into this absolute banger of a video, I'd just like to say that this video is sponsored by Deadly Serverless. They have a weekly whitelist, sponsored channels, PvP/PvE promos, lists, Discord for sale, and their promos are the cheapest around. My friend owns the server, so if you have anything you want to talk to him about for your own server, just let me know and I can get you in touch with him. But anyway, let's get back into the video. To start this one out, I went over to Extinction to farm up some electronics real quick, as this was all part of my plan to become the solo dominator, if you know what I'm talking about.
Because I just need I need electronics for some.
Because enforcers were banned, I had to farm these roly-poly bitch-ass looking ass motherfuckers. And, you know, it was really annoying because these shits have so much HP, bro. I then went to go get me some pearls because electronics were muy cheap over here. I then got some heavies up in my usual starter spot and prepared to go do my first small raid of the wipe.
What? He logged up? What the hell? Oh, big metal. Maybe. We'll put up a couple forges. I mean, okay. Take a thylacole, yeah. Definitely worth raiding this guy.
I then rolled my fat ass over to Gen 1 so I could tame up some tech strikes so I could do more raids later on.
Literally at 1 HP.
I then went over to Gen 2, right after Gen 1, because, you know, they're twins or something like that. And I went over to tame up some Spinos and Theries and other stuff like that so I could have some DPS tames for when I got into PvP and when I had to run other things like OSDs.
Yeah. New name for the berry. Ew. Yellow, I need. Hopefully, not get jumped. Obi.
After that, there's a nice juicy Tech Rex event, and it was green.
That's sick. These colors are. Did they know? Oh shit, there's a guy here. He's gonna jump on it. I just nagged my kibble.
It was now time for me to stand still and shoot my shotgun at something that doesn't move and do this for at least 10 minutes.
already have a better strike DP, I think, than what's in there, but those strikes are probably better than mine. Oh yeah, Ellie's probably boosted on it. Run! Alright, last shot.
Now, unfortunately, the video of this corrupted, I had raided this Lost Island crouch cave over here. Basically, all I did was put some C4 on a carbo and blow up the turrets. It was really like a 5-second raid. It's some nice mats for me, nothing too huge, but now we're going to get into moving in there and everything after that, so let's get back into it. After securing my main base, I went over to Rag as there had been a Racer Wild Dino event, and I ended up getting to some PvP.
Bro! Yeah, buddy.
I just wanted to give you guys a quick update on what base was looking like after I fully moved in. So here it is. Not much, pretty empty. Stegos were the next priority, so I went back over to Gen 1 to go and tame some up. I then got into another raid, but unfortunately the soaking part once again got cut out. I don't know, I need to fix my video software, but by now I have fixed it. But anyway, you get to watch me struggle at least, and you get to see the loot, so I mean, I guess you guys like that part, right?
Fucking my carbon. I got a roof.
And it's a bead. Oh, yes. Yes, black helmet. Yes, oh my god, I have a full set of good flat. Who doesn't even have metal on?
After that little bit of a raid that had a lot of loot, there was a raid base event over on Gen 2, so I went over there to try to do it as a solo and got into a ton of PvP.
Bruh. Ow. Fuck. Fuck! Bro, I didn't realize he pushed me.